Students, today topic is write something. So today's topic is shortest path algorithm. In your syllabus, if you could see that the shortest path algorithm has been categorized into three categories. One is single source shortest path problem for general graph. Another one is single source shortest path, especially for directed acyclic graph. And another one is all pair shortest path. That is, any particular node can be act as a source. So all pairs shortest path algorithm. So the first one, that is single source shortest path with respect to any kind of graph, will be addressed by Bellman-Ford algorithm. Especially the Bellman-Ford algorithm will work with a kind of graph which has negative edges. But this Dijkstra algorithm is very popular and very widely used almost in all the questions and all the syllabuses. It is compulsorily included. And this is meant for a directed, the graph should be a directed acyclic graph. And the Floyd-Warshall's algorithm is the one which accepts a graph and it tries to find the shortest path between all the pairs. So this is also very interesting algorithm. So let me first discuss about the Dijkstra algorithm. Before starting Dijkstra algorithm, let me welcome you to think about some points regarding the Prim's algorithm that we discussed in the last class. So when you talk about Prim's algorithm, the first thing you should keep in mind is it is the algorithm that is meant to construct a spanning tree, that is minimum spanning tree. So that means you have two algorithms for constructing the spanning tree with respect to minimum cost. One is Kruskal, another one is Prim's. What about Kruskal is, Kruskal tries to find distinct edges. While you are finding the distinct edges, after completing the step, you can find that the distinct edge together form a graph. But when you go for Prim's algorithm, the Prim's algorithm won't go for distinct edge. It will always go for connected edge. It will always go, it starts with one edge, go towards another edge, go towards another edge without taking the hand, without taking the edge. So like you draw a art, or like you draw a diagram using your pencil in a piece of paper by joining all the points without taking your hand. So like that, the Prim's algorithm works by finding the to find the shortest path. And if you could see that behavior of that Prim's algorithm, the same behavior can be applied for finding the shortest path using the Dijkstra algorithm, but with a little change in the concept. So what we are going to do with respect to Dijkstra algorithm is, in Dijkstra algorithm, you are going to create some set. Say for example, in this material, they mentioned as the set is SPT set. That is a shortest path tree. SPT means for shortest path tree set. You may have the same name or you may have a different name. So what you can do is, we have to make a two set. One set contains, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, now it's visible more than the previous one. So you have two sets. One set contains vertices including the shortest path tree. See, you have to maintain two set. Two set means you have to maintain two array. Two array you have to maintain, like a set set concept. In one array, you have to maintain the vertices that is included in the shortest path tree. That is when you are considering the tree. The another set is that is not visited. So every time you need to choose it. This node, that means vertex, or and if that vertex is not visited, then you have to put it in the not visited vertex set. If it is visited, then you have to put it in the visited set. So that's what you have to do. But every time when you are going to select a vertex from the non-visited set and to be put it in the visited set, you should think about that the vertex should have a minimum distance from the source, not from the immediate node. You should always think about that it should have a minimum distance from the source. That's the major point. So here the source is given and you have to fix the source, because if you look at the syllabus itself, it is mentioned that single source shortest path. So you need not have to change the source at all the time. The source is static. You have only one starting point. From that starting point, you need to find the path for every other distances. Say for example, let me take one thing, PowerPoint. What is that is? What is the idea here is? Yeah, yes. So you have a graph like this. You have a graph like this. Let me introduce the idea, then you can proceed further. You have a graph like this. You have a graph like this, and this is a single source shortest power problem. So this is treated as a source. Now you have to find the shortest distance for every other node from the source node. It has a direct connection here. It may have a direct connection from here, and it may have direct connection to this particular node like that. So say for example, this edge has a one as a cost. This edge has a edge two. This edge has a three. And this edge has a 5. Now you may feel that, say for example, this node is designated as A, and this node is designated as B, and this node is C, and this node D, this node F. So you may think that the path from A, that is the source, to that destination F at that particular time. Now that destination is F at that particular time, because every time you need to say that this is source, how to reach the node F if it is treated as a destination from the source node A. You may feel that since it is having a direct path, so you may treat that this is a shortest path. Say for example, this distance may be 15. Let me take 15. But what you can do is, here you have 4, that is a DTF. But if you could see that, instead of choosing a single path from the source to destination, which costs up to 15, let me take some alternate direction. The source to source A to B 1, B to C 2, C to 3, D 3, D to 4, D to F 4. So if you sum the distance 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4, so that means you have 10. So the total distance traveled from source to destination. So what you have to write is, while you are finding the Dijkstra algorithm, the shortest path from the source node A to the node F via, that means via, what are the things that you have to cross? Via B, C, D is 10. So like that, you have to do the idea. So that is the principle behind the Dijkstra algorithm. So that's what you need to do. One is visitor, another one is not visitor. So whenever you treat the node as a visitor, then that visitor node should have a minimum distance from the source. That's what you should think about it. Let me go into the material. So the same problem that we have discussed in the yesterday Prim's algorithm that is given here. See, this is the graph that we have discussed in the yesterday topic of discussing the Kruskal and Prim's. The same is taken here. So you have to maintain all the vertices. See, SPT set is an infinity. 0, infinity, infinity, infinity. So what it means is, so the time taken to reach 0 is 0. Because 0 is the node that is treated the source node. There is no weight. There is no distance. That is to be considered as a weight value to reach that node. So what you can do is, instead of reaching that node, what you can do is, all the other nodes you can treat as infinity, because you do not know other nodes from source node to reach that particular node. You don't know. So to start with the problem, you are initiating as infinity, infinity. Now, what is the first step? First step, you need to have another step. This is non-visited vertex, that is 0 to, another set is 0. So first one is visited is 0. You have to include the 0 to SPT set. So next, from 0, you can reach two nodes. One is 1, another one is 7. You can reach one node or 7 node. And which is, what is the shortest path? What is the shortest path? And which node you have to include? The node which is having 1. So now the 1 is joined to SPT set there. Now it reaches 1. Now you have to calculate from 1 what are the adjacent vertices. The adjacent vertices for 1 is 7 and 2. Now you have to calculate how to reach 7 from the source. So if you reach the 7 from the source, the distance traveled is from 0 to 1 and 1 to 7. So total distance traveled is 15. So whether you have to choose this distance or you can choose the direct distance. Since this is two more routes and two routes are having higher cost, so you are omitting this and you are taking this route. Likewise, what is the possible least distance to reach 2? So you have this path, 0, 1, 2. So total distance is 12. Otherwise, you have this path also, 0, 7, 6, 8, 2. Otherwise, 0, 7, 8, 2. So there are many paths like this. But while we are constructing the process using the Ricci algorithm, the one which is having the lesser distance will be taken as first. So that's what I consider. So now the least distance is treated as 7. And another after 7, it is taken as a 6, because for reaching 6, you have the same direction, 0 to 7, 8, and 7 to 6, 1. So total distance round is 9. So then you are added the 6. And after adding the 6, from 6, which is the minimum cost, so you have 5 and 8. If you could see that, you have 5 and 8. So 5 is reached by 2 and 8 is reached by 6. But if you calculate the distance, 0, 8, 8, 1, 6, totally 9, 15 cost. If you go this way, that is only 14 cost. 0, 1, 7, 2. How much? 12, 14. So when you are solving the problem, the shortest route from the shortest route to reach the 8 from A. So you can find those shortest distance. See, 14. Look at it here. See, this is the shortest distance. So if you go this way, the cost is maximum. So accordingly, you have to update the distance value in the visited vertex value. So when you are adding the rule, so the step is given here. See where you have created it. Assign a distance value to all vertices in the input graph. Initially, all distance value as infinite first. Assign distance value for the source vertex so that it is picked first. While set is SPT set doesn't include all vertices, pick a vertex U which is not there in the SPT set and has a minimum. So likewise, you include U to the set. Update distance value of all distance value of U. So while you are updating the distance value of all alternative, you have to think about that it is from the source. It is from the source. So how to calculate the source? Now I added the thing, I am saying that this is bigger. So instead of adding the value, you can take the difference. If you are taking the difference, then you have to check that whether it is less than the overall B or not, overall the distance covered or not. Accordingly, you have to assign it to the value. So this is, so and this step is repeatedly carried out. This third step is repeatedly carried out until all the vertices are included in the set SPT. So remember, in Prince and Kruskal algorithm also, you should visit all the vertex. But the path should not be a cycle. That's the condition. Likewise, here also you should reach all the vertex. But path should be the one that is starting from the source and reaches that particular node. So that it will give you a minimum path. Minimum path. That is, you should have at least return the minimum cost. So this is the way you can follow solution to the problem. There are some other author who discussed the solving procedure of Dijkstra algorithm as a tabulation method. So there are many methods available. So one method is the one that is explained here. Another is tabulation method. Here also you have to put another thing as source as another node as infinity. For each visiting, you have to remove the infinity value and you have to put the shortest value in that matrix. And finally, you have to return that matrix and you have to report the path to reach 4 via from 0 is via 7, 6, 5. That is the path. The path to reach 8 via 1 and 2. The path to reach 6 via 7 and 6. The path to reach 3 via 1 and 2. Like that, you have to mention the path. So that is the final answer that you need to proceed to give for. So if you leave the shortest path tree like this, then it looks like a output for the, what is that? Prince algorithm. So you should not leave that thing like that. So you should report for every node what is the minimum path from the source node. So you have to report the path. So the path to reach 8 from the source node 0 is Lakshmi Sholunga. The path to reach 8 from the source node 0.
8
the path to reach node 8 from the source node 0.
0 to 1.
Yes.
1 to 2.
Yes.
Up from 2 to 8.
Very good. So how much distance it has to be traveled? போட்டிருக்காங்க. That is different and this is different. Okay. So this is the answer. So the effort taken to reach node 2 from 0 is 12. That means the distance it travels. How it is that? So this edge cost is 4 and this edge cost is 8. 4 plus 8 you put together 12. Right?
Okay.
So in the circle ku mele potrukra cost ayum the line ku mele potrukra cost ayum neenga confuse panikka venda.
Okay. Okay.
ரைட்டா. சோ சர்க்கிளுக்கு மேல போட்டுக்கிற காஸ்ட் தான் நீங்க ஃபைனலா கொடுக்கக்கூடிய சொல்யூஷன். வேறஸ் லைன்ல போட்டுக்கக்கூடிய காஸ்ட் வந்து இட்ஸ் எ ப்ராப்ளம். இட்ஸ் எ ப்ராப்ளம். இத வொர்க் அவுட் பண்ணிட்டு தான் நம்ம அதை நம்ம சொல்யூஷன் கண்டுபிடிக்க போறோம். பட் இதோட நீங்க யூ ஷட் நாட் லிமிட் யுவர் ஆன்சர் லைக் திஸ். யூ ஷட் ரைட் இட். சோ ஏனா இது வந்து ஆல் சோர்ஸ். இது வந்து வாட் இஸ் தி சிங்கிள் சோர்ஸ் ஷார்ட்டஸ்ட் பாத் இல்லையா? அப்ப சோர்ஸ் ஒன்னு. அப்ப என்ன எழுதுறேன்னா பாத் ஃப்ரம் பாத் டு ரீச் 1 0 டு 1 path to reach 2 yo எப்படி எழுதணும் இப்படி இருக்கணும் path to reach let me draw a line here path to see I have a graph 0 path to reach 4 so 0 to 4 path reach பண்றதுக்கு என்னன்னலாம் நம்ம எழுதுற ஆன்சர் 0 அந்த graph பாத்தீங்க அப்படினா 0 1 2 then 4 இதோட total cost வந்து 12 அப்படினு எழுதணும் is the answer final answer likewise path to reach 0 to another node is 8 போற அப்ப அந்த பாத் எழுதணும் 0 ல இருந்து 8 க்கு போறோம்னா there might be many alternate paths you may find any alternate path original graph பாத்தீங்கன்னா you may find any alternate path but the path that is drawn that is find out using the digital algorithm such as to be reported as a summary summary 0 ல இருந்து 4 க்கு போறோம் 4 ல இருந்து 6 then 6 ல இருந்து 8 இப்படி குடுறோம் சோ இதோட டோட்டல் காஸ்ட் வந்து ஒரு 18 So likewise, you should completely report the answer. Now you understood?
Yes.
Okay. இதே மாதிரிதான் but what is the Bellman-Ford algorithm? Bellman-Ford algorithm is similar to the Dijkstra algorithm. But what is here is Bellman-Ford algorithm works for negative weight edges. What is mean negative weight edges? So in the graph, we have all positive values. But in here, we have negative values. In here, we have minus one. Or negative value, we have edge value. So the negative value but that if that negative value is there then your Dijkstra algorithm is not a good one to work out so in that case you have to go for Bellman-Ford algorithm but Dijkstra algorithm is taking less time big O of v log v whereas v is the vertex whereas the Bellman-Ford algorithm is a product of v and e that is product of vertex and the edge so time complexity is a little more than Bellman-Ford but the Bellman-Ford is more suitable for the graph which is having negative edge also this Bellman-Ford is well suited for distributed algorithm so I am not going to cover the problem the methodology working but not the problem it is a working methodology so I left it to you as a online assignment so you have to present and submit the so do you have the lecturing capability facility So if not so, you will start your lecture. I record it here and we'll upload the same, right?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So do you have any doubt here in the Dijkstra algorithm?
No, sir.
So if any graph is given to you, you should think about that way and you have to write, give the answer for that, right? Okay.
Okay, sir.
So let me stop the recording first.